The largest supermoon in decades.
Yes, my mom actually gave me a heads up last night. Ah. Yeah, she and my dad were lucky ducks sitting on the beach in Florida getting to see
it. Oh, wow.
That's a good spot. It's awesome. Well, we're joined now by Jason Smolinski, and he's with the Department of Physics and Astronomy at Calvin College, to talk about this supermoon. So now, from what I understand, then the last one we had was back in, what, the 40s?
The last one that was this close was certainly, yes, a long time ago, 1948, I believe.
Did it get bigger this time? Like, were we able to see some bigger shots?
Did it get bigger or not? The moon's not growing,
closer.
But it is getting closer. Yes,
right,
sir.
Right.
Sure. So it was roughly the same distance back in 1948. Interestingly enough, it was actually a bit closer toward the earlier 1900s.
Then. Oh, okay.
So explain that phenomenon for us. Why do we have the moon appear bigger at certain points in time than others?
Sure. So the moon, when the moon orbits around the Earth, it doesn't follow a circular path. It follows what's called an ellipse, which is basically an oval. And this oval is not centered on the Earth, but it's shifted a bit. So there's one end of the oval is closer to the Earth, and one end of the oval is farther away. So the closer point we call perigee. So it's when the moon is at perigee that we call it the closest point to the Earth. And then as this system sort of orbits around the sun, it can be oriented in any particular way when the moon, Earth, and sun line up in what we would call a full moon.
Right.
But it's at that particular position where the moon, Earth, sun line up while the orbit is also lined up like that, that we get this phenomenon that we call a supermoon.
So basically, though, when people are bummed because they see all these really cool pictures of this supermoon, how much do we have to wait now until everything's aligned just right for us to be able to see a supermoon again?
Yeah, well, the supermoon phenomena occurs about once a year. It's just a matter of whether it's particularly close or not, right? So it's actually a range. Whether the moon is specifically at that precise position of perigee or not, it can be off a little bit, right? And if it's off a little bit, it won't be quite as close, but it's still relatively close. So we'll have to wait until, 2034 or something like that for it to be this close again. But we'll have a supermoon next year, and actually even next month.
Okay, so you'll get to hopefully get some cool pictures of it.
Yeah. Just technically not quite as super of a supermoon.
Right, if you can catch all that, right?
So certainly a super duper moon.
A super duper, I like that. Thanks, Jason. Thanks, Ellen.